Hi friends, today I shall be speaking to our beloved godfather of denim, Adriano Goldschmidt, regarding his views on circularity in denim industry. Circularity is becoming so important and it's a step ahead of sustainability. And I wanted to have his views on what are the most important aspects of circularity in our industry and how we can strengthen it further. Hi Adriano.
Thank you so much, and thank you to give me one more opportunity because I'm almost a fixed guest in all what you do, and so I'm very proud of that.
We are proud and we are honored, actually, you know.
Okay, let's say today we're gonna talk about something that probably is not very familiar to everybody. You know, let's say we're going to talk about circular business, circular fashion, circular economy.
So what is your understanding of circular fashion or in denim specifically?
Let's say, first of all, is a kind of thing that is in development. Because it is a little bit like sustainability was 7, 8, 9 years ago. That, a few crazy people were talking about sustainability, but honestly, it was really difficult for the normal people to understand what it was. And, but what is phenomenal in some way is incredible speed that this, concept of sustainability had in the last years, and in particular now during the COVID, we had an acceleration, you know. Anyhow, I like to talk a little bit about circular because it's probably not very well known, and probably who has a kind of industrial mentality has a hard time to understand what circular means, because they're thinking about small numbers, they're thinking about something that is maybe regarding their son, but not really the operating people. But honestly, it's not really true. Let's say there is something that I suggest everybody to read, that is redesign jeans, that is a kind of guideline to circular denim that is published from Ellen MacArthur Foundation, that in some way we could say they are being probably in the group of the first people really fighting for circular economy. And today they are still, I would say, the leader and the ones that are giving direction. First of all, talking about our industry, I have to say there are two different points of view, because one thing is what circular fashion means for a mill, that no, it's not easy understandable, because a mill could say, listen, I'm producing new fabric. You know, whatever they do after with my fabric is not my business. Looks logical, but the reality is not, because who is driving the business at the end is a consumer.
Yeah.
And when the consumer is asking something, we have to be able to respond. Another point of view is the one that is regarding manufacturing, that in some way even more complex. But let's go for a second to the mills. Let's say the mills, basically, they have to give life to the circular fashion using recycled materials, most they can, or using fibers like, for instance, Refibra of Lenzig, Refibra is a fiber that contains already some, contains cotton, but contains, is a recycled post-consumer and pre-consumer both. And let's say whatever material they are using is very important that they use something that is coming from recycling. This one is very important fact. There is one point that I really care about highlight that is about recycled polyester. Many mills, they are thinking to do a right thing, bringing into their collection recycled polyester, because they are thinking we totally know what is happening about the plastic bottles, the micro polyester and all that. But reality is that from the point of view of circular, we create a damage using polyester recycle.
Especially with microfibers.
Yeah, especially microfibers, because a very simple, the preliminary concept of circular fashion is that whatever you do has to be recyclable. And when you make a polyester blend in your fabric, basically is not recyclable anymore, because you are not able to separate the cotton or the hemp or whatever it is from the polyester. So I know that doesn't look logical, but the truth is I'm totally fine recycling plastic bottle, but let's say the destination of that product has to be different from fabrics because we create another problem with the fabric.
Yes.
I think the recycled polyester has to go to make new bottles, make plastic containers, make insulation material for the building industry, but not textile. On the other side, I think I like to talk a little bit about the manufacturing. Manufacturing basically is the guy that really is making the garment. And so obviously is coming much more into the circle of recycling and circular fashion. Let's say the most important thing is a very simple concept, that everything goes in the gene has to be recyclable. Right now, most of the manufacturers are thinking, okay, I'm using a fabric that is already recycled, I'm okay. You are not okay. You are not okay. Let's say, of course, you did a small step in the right direction, but it's not enough. What you have to do is to list all the materials that you put in the jeans. And I mentioned just a few. The thread cannot be a polycotton. Has to be, for instance, in my experience, the best fiber is a tencel that is recyclable and strong, is stronger than cotton in terms of physical data. Then obviously you have the fabric, you have the pocketing again cannot be polycotton. Cannot be polycotton. You have the labels. You know, the labels typically since 50 years, I don't know how many years.
100 years.
Yeah, they are made in polyester and doesn't work. Leather, for instance. Leather, we love leather, but let's say is a material that today is against our principles. I bring a subject, for instance, one important thing is to substitute the leather. And the leather, I found a company in Mexico that they substitute the leather with biotechnology they making a product that is basically using cactus, that obviously
cactus,
available in Mexico.
That's and, the
a big problem, obviously, when we talk about recycling are buttons and rivets. Buttons and rivets are in metal. And let's say they need to be away from the material that you recycle. So there are two possibilities. Is one to create a button that you can extract from the garment very, very easy. Or like I'm doing very, very frequently, I'm using a natural button that can be destroyed during the recycling.
Okay.
In particular, corozo, for instance, mm-hmm. is an amazing material.
Which material? Corozo.
Okay. And there is then, of course, all the packaging has to give on your attention. Shipping bags, they need to be biodegradable. So let's say, easy to say everything goes into the gin, has to be recyclable, but to make it happen, honestly,
it's very difficult.
But we arrive to that, because honestly, I know when we like to do something, and we are determined, nothing is impossible. We're going to do it.
Absolutely. And what about spandex? I don't know.
Huh?
About the spandex. Also the spandex part in the
fabric. Spandex is another problem, obviously. Because let's say the regular spandex and lycra is oil derivated. And they are today... let's say research and a few products that they are a substitute. The one that in some way for me is more interesting is natural rubber.
And yet, that,
yeah. And anyhow, it's something that is in the process. And it's also there, it's gonna happen. But let's say it's a lot of research, experimentation, but let's say for sure that is a direction. Probably the audience is asking, what is happening? What is circular fashion? Circular fashion means, to make it simple, there are many ways in some way to recycle things. Let's say, what is the reason? Because also, probably somebody's gonna ask, why we have to recycle? Why we have to make a circular fashion? The answer is very simple. In the world today, we produce more of what Mother Nature is giving to us. So it's not circular fashion, is not an option, it's an obligation.
That's a very good definition.
So we don't have any other chance. And we have to, first of all, obviously, on one side, we need to talk about sustainability, because it's a very important segment of do the things better. But also, this one is not enough. Even if all our process is coming at emission zero, and with no chemicals, a little water or whatever, still we are in trouble. That's why circular fashion is important. To going back, let's say the first thing that is, let's say circular is about that when you are tired of your jeans, you sell it to somebody else. Let's say, I know that is a practice that is not very popular in many, many countries. You know, I live in Los Angeles, and the vintage store is very, very popular for the young generation. First of all, because it's less money. Second, because in some ways more creative shopping, because every garment is different from the other. Mm. You know, but for sure it's coming something that is coming in more and more popular. Then there is what I call upcycle. Basically, you take a garment, maybe you cut in a few parts, or you reuse the garment to make a new one. It is a kind of thing that especially young designers loves to do it. And we see that they are growing. And the other fact that is obviously very important is that for sure has an immediate industrial use is to create a fiber. Basically recycling old garments, we can create new fiber and then a new fabric. Your guest was also Andrea of Officina 39. Yeah. He does something that honestly is amazing because he is recycling the color. Basically from the color garment, he extract the color and he create a new color. This is in the story of the circular economy. And one thing that is very important that we have to learn also as a mill or designing fabric, that is about transparency. Transparency and traceability of the materials that we are using. Because you understand that it's very hard to recycle a fiber if you don't know what it is. You know, obviously you need to give you need to give the information to the people that they are operating in that segment, but also the consumer. They are anxious to know where is it coming from. It was an old jeans. No, it was not. It was dying after or whatever. All the information are part in some way of this new world.
Do you see blockchain technologies being, you know, being more useful in the coming years and being more used, actually useful there already, but being used more?
And I know that for sure you're asking me what is the status of the industry today regarding circular.
Absolutely.
And let's say it's very small. It's no question. We are really at the first steps. And let's say, to be honest, every decent mill in the world today, they have in the collection 1, 2, 3, 5 items that they are using recycled cotton or recycled fibers. And let's say it is something that is starting, you know, for what is regarding manufacturing is much more behind. Because yes, they are using the recycled fibers, but to be honest, they not been considering yet the list of all the components that they are going in into the jeans. So what I have to say is we are at the very beginning, but we have experience that things are happening very fast. And probably COVID is giving a very strong acceleration to all the processes. In any area that can be from digitalization to inventing new system to dye, to recycle the product, to upcycle the garment. So things that today are not looking like real, they're gonna come real very, very quickly. And so if I can give a suggestion to who operates in the denim industry, don't be conservative. means have an open mind, means get ready for the future. In my opinion, who is ready for the future is going to be a winner. Who is not is going to be a loser. You know, loser means that it goes out of business. So they're going to be very, very important change in the supply chain. And who's giving attention and takes some risk is the one that probably is gonna get an award in the future.
Absolutely.
And
I didn't want to ask one more thing. You know, in terms of let's say when we look at different levels of development of countries, you know, the developed countries and the not developing countries and the poorer countries. So the circularity, do you think becomes more important in the developed countries where the consumers kind of are more used to use and throw, whereas in developing countries or poorer countries, you know, there are different stratas of society and then the garment keeps on being used down the line?
Let's say circular fashion is very complicated, you know, because there are a lot of problems that they are connected to the location, to how to collect the garments. And there are many, many subjects that they need to be solved. It's not like ordering a pizza. It's something much more difficult, and we have to be very, very determined. What I have to say, anyhow, that the trend is very, very clear, you know, and that is a way, is no other way. So we have to be ready for that. And
you already mentioned about the Ellen Mercator Foundation. Of course, that's the most important circular reference, you know, for the circularity. Any other references you would like to suggest?
Yeah, let's say what I would like to talk a little bit about what is happening in the market in terms of probably the question is, but who's doing that? Okay. What is the development of this business? How is getting developed? And there are a few things that I would like to mention that in some way are, let's say, the top of the iceberg in some way. Let's say there are, for instance, it is very impressive what H&M is doing in Stockholm with the Hong Kong Research Institute of Textile. Basically, they created a machine that they put in the flagship store in Stockholm, where basically they recycle in the store the garment that the customer is bringing into. It is a business, for sure is not. You know, I don't know how much money the machine is costing, but from what I understand, they can recycle, I don't know, 10, 15 pieces every day. But there is a very important factor that is a tremendous tool for the education of the consumer. You know, I just mentioned at that level something that in some way was taking my attention. You know, Nespresso, they make capsules for coffee. And some years ago, they started a strategy of asking the customer to send back the used capsules. To be honest, everybody was laughing, including myself. I would say, I'm not gonna send back the coffee capsules. But the reality is that today I do it, and the project is working. So what I'm saying is that what doesn't look realistic today, we have to give a lot of attention because can work in the future. And let's say it's not only H&M, because there are many small brands that they are giving pressure to their customer to bring back their jeans. Some of them they upcycle, some of them they are connected with some mill that is recycling the fabric. But it's coming something very common, especially north of Europe, that is more sensitive to, let's say in general, climate change and circularity. Honestly, is working. There is another thing that I did personally, and I was very surprised. I have a friend of mine that owns, he opened a new store in Los Angeles called Gallery Department. And talking together is a guy that in some ways recycling denim, selling the denim, the vintage denim. In some cases, he overprint or he upcycled the garment, but most of the case, no. And so I said to him, why we don't rewash the garment, okay? And so we've been using Wiser Wash, that you know is a tremendous tool to make very good washes. And to be honest, the result was incredible. It was totally a different product. And this guy was sold out in a few days. Wow. And took so much attention that a few weeks ago, he got almost a full page on the New York Times, that you know what it is.
Yeah.
It's not a, it is the most important newspaper in the world. And they dedicated a page to what he does, what he's recycling. And we did also the same into French Terrace, Champions, and so we're getting an incredible good result. And to be honest, today I'm thinking about the millions of pieces that they are sitting in the warehouse of the big brands. Think about, I'm sure that Champion has millions of pieces that they are not able to sell. And as the same thing for the Gap or Navy, and every brand honestly have that problem. And circular fashion means also that we take all those resources and we bring it to the market again.
In a new way and with a new look.
Yeah. Let's say it is, at the end, a very creative work, because everybody, every designer can have an idea and can become something, you know. And
this is a wonderful concept.
Yeah. And I have to say one thing that we know this because we've been talking many times. To improve and to make a better planet, we need everybody. We need the industry, we need the governments, we need the institution, but the most important thing is the people. It's the people that is buying the stuff, that is making the market. And when they change their mind and they go into a direction, they take after them all the industry. So to be honest, we don't have a choice.
This is the only way.
Yeah. And I have to say, in my opinion, circularity is what sustainability was, I don't know, 5-7 years ago, you know. And today we know what it is. Tell me one thing, all your customers, I don't think that we cannot find one that is not telling us that he's sustainable.
You know, everybody is.
Yeah. Maybe some of them, they are lying. We know that.
And we really hope, you know, that the brands, let's say 2 years or 3 years or 5 years down the line, every brand can say that we are circular. You know, that would be something very important to say.
Anyhow, this one, I'm happy to do that. We've been able to talk about this because I know all the mills, designers, and are thinking about what the post-COVID is. And honestly, this one is one for sure.
Absolutely. This is a major direction to be visible in the next few years.
Yeah, for sure. We're going to see a lot of things happening.
Thank you. So, thank you, Adrian. It's, you know, it's always so wonderful to learn from you, you know, and I, you know, so many practical examples, practical references you have given, which are so inspiring. And from every talk of yours, I'm very sure, and I get the feedbacks from my readers and from the viewers also that they learn a lot of new things. So I'm sure from this talk also a lot of people will be inspired. And
thank you. I like to make my part and try to help with my experience and my research and put people together. That is what you do. You know,
no, I'm a very small person. I'm a very small person. But yes, your experience and your you know, knowledge and experience is so vast, and it helps the industry a lot.
Yeah, and we have to make it available to everybody.
Yes, definitely.
So, thank you so much.
Thank you so much for being here, and I really
it was a real pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Bye-bye. Bye.